Hello students, welcome back to Let Us Master English. Today, let us study the poem Fire and Ice written by Robert Frost for class 10th CBSE. Let us get started. Fire and Ice, the poet of this poem is Robert Frost, a great American poet. It is a popular literary device on account of its contradictory subject matter of Earth's destruction and the ending. It was first published in 1920 in New Hampshire. The poem expresses the profound idea that world would end in one of two ways, either by ice or fire. So, इस poem में poet आपको बता रहा है कि ये दुनिया का एक दिन अंत होगा. ये अंत आइस के द्वारा भी हो सकता है या फिर फायर के द्वारा हो सकता है. नाउ लेट अस रीड द फर्स्ट स्टैंजा. सम से द वर्ल्ड विल एंड इन फायर, सम से इन आइस. फ्रॉम व्हाट आई हैव टेस्टेड ऑफ डिजायर, डिजायर मीन्स अ स्ट्रॉन्ग फीलिंग ऑफ वॉन्टिंग टू हैव समथिंग. I hold with those who favor fire. Favor means support. So students, the poet says that this existing world will come to an end one day. People are divided on this issue. Some believe that this world will end in fire. The fire of passions and desire will lead to the end of the world. Some people think that this world will end in ice. Cold reasoning and hate will lead this world to destruction. However, the poet has experienced passions of love and desire. He supports those who believe that fire of passions and desires will lead to the destruction of this existing world. So, poet कह रहा है कि लोग सोचते हैं कि ये दुनिया का एक दिन अंत होगा. कुछ लोगों का कहना है कि इसका कारण क्या होगा, फायर. सो फायर इज यूज्ड हियर सिंबॉलिकली, फायर ऑफ पैशंस एंड डिजायर. और कुछ लोग सोचते हैं कि दुनिया का जो अंत होगा वो आइस की वजह से होगा. आइस इज सिंबॉलिक ऑफ हेट्रेड, इनसेंसिटिविटी, इनडिफरेंस एंड सो ऑन. तो पोएट कहता है कि मैंने भी इन भावनाओं को टेस्ट किया है, तो मैं उन लोगों के पक्ष में हूं जो सोचते हैं कि इस दुनिया का अंत फायर की वजह से होगा. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस डिस्कस सम क्वेश्चंस. व्हाट कैन बी द कॉज ऑफ वर्ल्ड्स डिस्ट्रक्शन एज पर दीज लाइंस. ऑप्शन वन फायर, बी आइस, C, both A and B, D, none of these. So your answer is both A and B. Second question, according to the poet, fire refers to, options are violent desires, passions, jealousy, or all of these. So the correct answer is all of these. Fire refers to violent desires, passions, and jealousy. What does ice symbolize? Indifference, love, sympathy, or passions? So the answer is indifference. Number four, what message does the poet want to convey through this poem? A, everything is transitory. Transitory means lasting only a short time, for a short time. Life is unpredictable, that cannot be predicted. Death is inevitable. Inevitable means something that can't be avoided, impossible to avoid. D, both A and C. So our correct answer is both A and C. So in your paper, you will be asked MCQs like this. Now students, let us study the second stanza. If it had to perish twice, perish means die, I think I know enough of hate to say that for destruction, ice is also great and would suffice. Suffice means be sufficient. So here, the poets say that fire can bring the destruction of the existing world. But if this existing world has to be destroyed not once but twice, that is two times, then ice is also strong enough to do this job. The poet has seen and experienced enough of hatred in this world. So cold reasoning, devoid of human feelings, only produces hate. And this cold reasoning is like ice. Ice itself is sufficient enough to cause the destruction of this world. और सेकेंड स्टेंजा में पोएट कह रहा है कि अगर इस वर्ल्ड का जो एंड है वो एक बार नहीं दो बार होना हो तो वो कहता है कि मैं सोचता हूं कि मैंने बहुत सारी नफरत देखी हुई है. So this ice is symbolic of hatred. और ये जो hatred है ये भी sufficient है इस दुनिया का अंत करने के लिए. Now students, let's discuss some questions based on this stanza. First line is, but if it had to perish twice? So what does it here refer to? Options are fire, ice, earth or world. So the correct option is world. The word perish means decay, lose one's life, appear or improve. So the answer is decay. Here the rhyming scheme used by the poet is, so the rhyme scheme of this stanza is ABABA. Question number 4. What does the poet want to convey through this poem? A. We should not be greedy. B. All humans should check their desires and hatred. C. Restrain our desires and love fellow beings. D. Both A and C. So the correct option is both A and C. Now students, what does fire and ice symbolize? Fire symbolizes greed, conflict, fury, cruelty, lust, avarice. And ice symbolizes hatred, insensitivity, coldness, intolerance, indifference and rigidity. So you must remember these words. Now let us discuss the poetic devices appearing in the poem. Number 1 is assonance. Assonance is the repetition of vowel sounds in the same line, such as the long sound of O in I hold with those who favor fire. So the vowel O is repeated here many times in hold, those, who or favor. So we can say that the poetic device assonance is used here. Second poetic device used is alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of consonant sounds in the same line, such as the sound of F in I hold with those who favor fire. So favor and fire, both these words start with the consonant F. Third poetic device is imagery. Imagery is used to make readers perceive things involving their five senses. For example, some say the world will end in fire, and to say that for destruction, ice is also great. So students, here when we read such lines, we are able to create a mental picture using our senses. Next poetic device used is symbolism. Symbolism is a use of symbols to signify ideas and qualities by giving them symbolic meanings different from their literal meanings. So here fire is the symbol of desires and ice symbolizes hatred. Next poetic device used is anaphora. Anaphora refers to the repetition of a word or expression in the first part of some verses. For example, some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. So some say, it is repeated. So the poetic device anaphora is used here. Next figure of speech is personification. Personification is to give human qualities to non-human or inanimate objects. In this poem, fire and ice are capable of destruction. Therefore, the poet personifies fire and ice by giving them a mind which is capable of destroying almost anything. So as humans destroy, so fire and ice are also capable of destruction. Next poetic device used here is enjambment. It is defined as a thought or clause that does not come to an end at a line break. Rather, it moves over to the next line. So here we can say that one line rolls onto the next line. There is no comma or full stop at the end. For example, from what I have tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. So these are the poetic devices used in this poem. Now students, it's time to discuss the theme of the poem. The central idea around which the entire poem revolves is that only love, equality, mutual understanding, and sympathy for one and all can help in establishing peace on the earth. The main theme of fire and ice is that human emotions are destructive when allowed to run unbridled. They can destroy a person morally, mentally, and physically. In this poem, Frost points out that humans will be the agents of their own destruction one way or the other. He seems to compare desire to fire and hate to ice. Too much fire and passion can quickly consume a relationship, while cold indifference and hate can be equally destructive. So students, I hope this poem is quite clear to you. For more such videos, kindly subscribe my channel and please do not forget to press the bell icon for the latest updates. If you like this video, so please press the like button. Please subscribe and share my videos with your friends. Thank you very much.